Welcome to No More Risk. At FM Global Emergency Response Consultants, our loss control efforts are based on sound engineering practices and effective human element programs. Today, we're focusing on fire pump inspections and the ability of facility personnel to manually start the diesel-driven fire pump. This is one of many human element activities intended to minimize loss during a fire event. An inoperative fire pump constitutes an impairment to your fire protection system, and action should be taken to return the pump to service without delay. Meanwhile, impairments should be managed using the FM Global Red Tag Permit System. Fire protection systems are only as strong as their weakest link, and the fire pump is considered to be the heart of the system. Without the pump, water pressure and volume to the sprinklers could be inadequate. This condition may cause too many heads to operate, reducing water flow to the fire, resulting in an uncontrolled fire event, and increasing property damage and business interruption. As a result, it's imperative that the fire pump starts as designed. The best way to ensure that it does is to implement a rigorous inspection, testing, and maintenance program. Having a good inspection, testing, and maintenance program in place is great, and that should be our focus. But what if your fire pump fails to start automatically during a fire event? This could occur for many reasons, such as damage to the fire pump controller, an obstruction within the pressure sensing line, improper setup for automatic start, or even a criminal act. Oftentimes during training, when asked how they would manually start the diesel-driven fire pump at their facility, if they haven't received proper training, a common answer is to proceed to the controller switch, set it to the manual mode, and press the start button. While this may be effective in some situations, there are conditions when this technique may not be the best answer. There should always be someone available to manually start the pump, and since time is of the essence, the time to train this person on the complexities of this process is before the fire event occurs. Here at FM Global Emergency Response Consultants, we can ensure that your team is properly trained. Now let's look at some key things you should see at your fire pump, which are important for personnel to understand. First, two manual starting contactors, one for each battery, should be provided at the engine. Fuel controls should be provided at the engine, and cooling controls should also be provided at the engine. The sequence for emergency manual operation arranged in step-by-step manner is posted nearby or on the pump driver. In summary, always have qualified and properly trained personnel assigned to your emergency response organization who will understand and follow the manufacturer's guidelines for manually starting the diesel driver for your pump. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on No More Risk.